Hi everyone, in today's video, I will be demonstrating step by step how to create a dynamic monthly expense bar chart in the project cost trackers projects overview tab. This chart will display the total monthly expenses for a selected project in addition to the existing project expense by date chart, which shows daily totals. Previously, I have created a tutorial video on this project cost tracker and you can find it on my YouTube channel page. In the projects overview tab, there is an expense transaction history table that records expense transactions by date for the selected project. To create a monthly expense chart for the project, we first need to organize the expense date by month. Start by converting the expense date into their respective months and years. To do this, go to a blank column on the right. Enter the following formula: equal date, year, expense date column, which is from cell G31 until, let's say, 1000, then month G31 to G1000. We need to change the format of the column into month and year format. To do this, select the column Q, go to format, select the number format, and select month and year format. This formula reconstruct each entry's date to reflect the first day of the month using the year and month from the expense date column. All dates will be converted to the first of their respective month. Next, we need to use filter function to exclude any blank or empty cells under the expense date column. To do this, we just need to add a filter function in front of the existing formula to exclude any blank or empty cell within the cell of G31 until G1000. If you are using Excel, keep in mind that the filter function only works in Excel for Microsoft 365, Excel 2021, and the webpage version. Now there's a list of dates with the first day of each month. We need to remove the duplicates in this list. To do this, we use sort and unique formula. Simply add sort and unique formula in front of this formula and it will show you only the unique month and year in this list. Next, we will calculate the total expenses for each month. In the column next to the list of months, use SUMIFS formula to calculate the total expenses for each month. In the first cell, enter SUMIFS formula, select the sum range, which is the total amount column, select N31, let's say to 1000. The criteria range one will be the expense date column from G31 until G1000. The criteria will be quotation greater equal quotation and date year Q1 month Q1. So the first criteria is to calculate the total amount. If the date is greater or equal to the month in the Q1 cell, then enter the criteria range, which is the same as this one, G31 until G1000. Second criteria is quotation smaller equal quotation and end of month formula Q1. The second criteria is to calculate the total if the dates in the expense date column smaller or equal to the month in Q1 cell. We need to change the format of the column to the currency that you prefer. Just go to the format cell, select the currency that you prefer and click OK. This formula sums the total expenses if the expense date falls between the first and last day of each month in the list. After this, use your cursor to select the bottom right corner of the first cell in this column R. Drag it down to apply it to all rows in the column. Finally, let's create a bar chart for the monthly expenses. Highlight the column of the month and expenses. Go to Insert, select the bar chart. Click on this chart and edit the data. Go to select data, remove series 1, enter the axis level, which is Q column. The Y value will be R column. Then click OK. We can further customize the chart by double click it. You can remove the border. You can change the text color into the color you want. you can add a title to the chart, or you can even enlarge it to make it more clear. So this is how the monthly expense chart looks like. When you change the project name from the drop-down list, it will change accordingly. I hope this video helped those who want to create a monthly expense chart in the project overview tab. If you found it useful, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and thanks for watching until the end. See you in the next video.